Good morning, my dear students. Today in wireless communication, let us start the unit 4, multipath mitigation techniques, which are the techniques used for reducing the effects of multipath propagation. Already we have known what is multipath propagation and what are the effects of multipath propagation. When a signal is transmitted, the propagation mechanisms like reflection, diffraction and scattering will make the signal to get diverted into various directions. Due to the diversion, these signals travel along various paths and finally reach at the receiver at different time interval. Since these signals come from various directions, they are received at the receiver with a different amplitude, different time delay and a different phase delay. Due to the multipath propagation, the modulation bandwidth increases and thus the inter-symbol interference will occur. This inter-symbol interference will increase the bit error rate and thus the distortion will be increased at the receiver. One more effect due to the multipath propagation is the channel impairments, which will cause the signal fading at the receiver. There are three techniques which are used for reducing the effects of multipath propagation. First one, equalization to compensate for inter-symbol interference. Second one, diversity to compensate for fading due to the channel impairments. Third one is channel coding, which will act as the error correction code. The examples of some channel coding are block code, convolution code. Even though there are three techniques used for reducing the effects of multipath propagation, in our syllabus we have only two, equalization and diversity. So now let us start from equalization. The equalization is the technique used for compensating the inter-symbol interference created by the time dispersive nature of the channel. If the modulation bandwidth will exceed the coherence bandwidth, then the inter-symbol interference occurs. This inter-symbol interference produces bit errors. Therefore, it is the major obstacle for the high-speed transmission. Generally, the channel's behavior change with respect to time. So, there is a need of an equalizer to track the time-varying nature of the channel. So these equalizers are called as the adaptive equalizers. So these adaptive equalizers will track the change in the behavior of the channel. There are two operating modes for adaptive equalizers. One is training and another one is tracking mode. At the time of training mode, a pseudo random binary signal or a fixed binary bit pattern is applied as the training sequence. This training sequence allows the equalizer to properly choose the filter coefficients even in worst channel conditions. The adaptive equalizer at the receiver uses a recursive algorithm to estimate the filter coefficients to compensate for the distortion. Once the training is finished, then we can say that the filter coefficients are near the optimal values. At the time of tracking, when user data is received, the adaptive equalizer algorithm will track the change in the behavior of the channel. So based on the change in the behavior of the channel, the adaptive equalizer is continuously changing its filter characteristics. If the equalizer is properly trained, it is said to be converged. The time over which the equalizer converges is a function of the equalizer algorithm, the equalizer structure, and the time rate of change of multipath radio channel. The adaptive equalizers need the training periodically to maintain the effective ISI cancellation. These equalizers are used in digital communication systems where user data are segmented and sent in terms of short time blocks or time slots. So these adaptive equalizers are well suited for the TDMA, where the data are transmitted in the form of blocks. So the training sequence is usually sent at the beginning of each block. This is the block diagram of a communication system where the equalizer is connected in the receiver. The original input signal is denoted as x of t. the combined impulse response of the transmitter, channel and the receiver is denoted by f of t. The output of the communication system is affected by the noise nb of t. The net output of the communication system is given to the equalizer as the input, which is denoted by y of t. The impulse response of the equalizer is heq of t. Then the output of the equalizer is denoted by d cap of t, which is given to the decision maker in order to produce the proper output, which should be approximately equivalent to the input signal x of t. The difference between the output of the decision maker and the output of the equalizer is called the error signal, which is used for adjusting the filter characteristics of the equalizer. From this black diagram, x of t is the original input signal, f of t is the combined impulse response of the transmitter, channel and the receiver, and the noise is nb of t. So the output of the communication system is y of t, which is the convolution of the input signal x of t and the complex conjugate of the impulse combined impulse response f of t plus the noise signal nb of t. This y of t is applied to the equalizer as the input, where the impulse response of the equalizer is heq of t. Therefore, the output of the equalizer d cap of t is the convolution between the input of the equalizer and the impulse response of the equalizer. Already y of t is x of t convolution f star of t plus nb of t. This total equation is taken with convolution by heq of t. So when the convolution is taken for the first term, x of t convolution f star of t convolution heq of t. Similarly, the second term is also taken with convolution nb of t convolution heq of t. In this equation, the convolution between f star of t and heq of t is assumed as g of t. Then this equation will become as x of t convolution g of t plus nb of t convolution heq of t. This is the expression of the impulse response of the equalizer. In this equation, if you assume nb of t as 0, the second term is completely neglected. Then in order to make the error as 0, the error is nothing but the difference between the actual output d of t and the output of the equalizer d cap of t. This difference should be equal to 0. Already we know the output of this decision maker is nothing but the input, which is approximately equivalent to the original input signal x of t. So d of t is already x of t. In order to make this expression, this difference is 0, then this d cap of t should be equal to x of t. How we should obtain this d cap of t as x of t? From this expression, already this second term is 0. Then from the first term, x of t convolution g of t, we should get this d cap of t as x of t. If g of t is del of t, then convolution between x of t and del of t is nothing but x of t. So this d cap of t will become x of t when g of t is del of t. G of t is nothing but the convolution between f star of t and heq of t, which is also equal to del of t. Then if we apply the Fourier transform, this will be expressed in frequency domain as f star of minus f, which is the Fourier transform of f star of t. The convolution now becomes the product. Then the Fourier transform of heq of t is heq of f. Then the total expression in frequency domain is f star of minus f into heq of f is equal to 1. This equation indicates that the equalizer is an inverse filter of the channel. That means the frequency components with smaller amplitude are amplified by the equalizer, and the frequency components with larger amplitude are attenuated by the equalizer. So this is the function of the equalizer.